The narrator's parents sent for them in the city. When the parents were comfortably settled in the city, they called the grandmother and Khushwant Singh from the village. The school was attached from the city. It was a turning point in their friendship. You have to keep in mind why it was a turning point, because now some changes will take place. They shared the same room. No doubt in the city they were sharing the same room, but Khushwant Singh's grandmother was no longer went to school with him. She was not able to accompany the child to school. Why? The narrator used to go to the English medium school, and especially in school bus. The bus used to pick him from the home, send him back at the home. There were no dogs in the streets. Second change. Now whom to feed in the city? So grandmother took to feeding the sparrows. She has got the change. Years rolled by. Now the time was passing day by day. They saw less of each other. Sometimes she would ask him what the teacher had taught him. In the beginning, she used to ask him when he came back home. She did not believe in the things they taught at the English school. Because in the English school, what is taught? Science, mathematics, music, and all these things. The narrator used in the school, she was unhappy. Because she thinks that the moral education, education about the religion is must, and that is not given to the student. She did not like the English or science, especially. She felt that there was no teaching about God and scriptures in the school. They don't teach about holy books. They don't teach about God in the school. The narrator one day told her that they were being given the music lessons. And she was very much disturbed, because according to her, music is not good for the gentle people. The narrator went to university. Now the another change. Now after growing up, the narrator Khushwant Singh went to the university for higher education. So now he is grown up. He needs privacy. So he was given a room of his own. That was the common link which they were sharing. And it was also broken now. The friendship was broken. The grandmother accepted her loneliness quietly. Now she used to live all alone. Child used to live alone in the room. She was always busy with her spinning wheel. You know, the ladies used to do the spinning wheel, charkha karte hain, and reciting the prayers. She rarely talked to anyone, never talked to anyone. Only in the afternoon she relaxed. Not to sleep, that too, only to feed the sparrows in the courtyard. She sat in the veranda. She broke the bread into little bits, in the small pieces. Then she would throw the bread to them. Hundreds of sparrows came there. They created a hell of noise. They create so much noise. Different birds create different noises. Some came and sat on her legs. Others came and sat on the shoulders. Some even on the head. She smiled because she feels happy, but never frightened them away. Feeding the sparrows, it was the happiest half an hour for the day for her. The narrator decided to go abroad. Now he wanted to go abroad, foreign country, for the further studies. For higher studies, he was to remain there for 5 years. So the grandmother was very old. She showed no emotion. Nobody knows when he will come back, she would be there or not. The narrator was worried also, but the grandmother was not upset. She came to the railway station to see him off, to say him goodbye. Her lips moved in prayer. Even she was busy in the prayer. Her mind was lost in the prayers. Her fingers were busy telling the beads of the rosary. She kissed his forehead silently, and the narrator thought perhaps it was the last physical contact between them. Because when he will come back after 5 years, since she is so old, maybe he won't be able to see her again after 5 years. But that was not the case. The narrator returned home after 5 years. His grandmother met him at the station. She did not look a day older. She did not speak anything. Even on that day, she held him in her arms. She went on reciting her prayers. She was still have no time for the words. In the afternoon, she fed the sparrows as usual. But in the evening, a change came over her. She did not pray, and Khushwant Singh was surprised. In the last so many years, this is the first time he has seen that she omitted her prayer. What she did, she collected the woman of the neighborhood, got an old drum, and started thumping the old drum for several hours, as if she was celebrating the homecoming of a warrior. Khushwant Singh said, "We tried to stop her. She might overstrain herself." It was for the first time that she had forgotten to pray. Kushwant Singh was shocked. The next morning, she fell ill. Because she was so old, she had a mild fever. Light fever was there. She told them that her end was near. She realized that she had forgotten to pray. Before the close of the last chapter of the life, she omitted her prayers. She didn't want to talk to. It would be waste of time. She ignored everybody's request. She lay peacefully in the bed. She was praying and telling the beads. And her lips stopped all over suddenly. The rosary fell from the lifeless fingers. Her face looked pale but peaceful now. She was dead. She was laid on the ground. She was covered with a red shawl. Arrangements for her funeral were being made. But when in the evening, Kushwant Singh said, the sun was setting, they brought the wooden stretcher, which we used to call the arthi. They stopped halfway in the courtyard. Why? Because right from the courtyard up to the way where she was lying on the ground, thousands of sparrows were sitting. They did not chirp. Today there was no sound. Can you imagine? Thousands of sparrows were sitting and there was no sound. Everyone felt sorry for the birds because they thought the birds have come for the food. The narrator's mother, Kushwant Singh's mother, brought some bread. She broke it into the little crumbs like the grandmother used to do and threw the crumbs to the sparrows. But you can imagine, the sparrows took no notice of them. Then they carried her dead body outside. The sparrows flew away quietly. The crumbs of the bread still remained lying there in the courtyard. That means the sparrows, they have come to feel sorry over the death of their friend, of death of the grandmother, not for the food. Even the birds, they are sensitive, they are emotional. They know the meaning of love. They know the meaning of friendship. So they were feeling sorry over the death of the grandmother.